Praise God, dear heart. Thank you for joining me again today on the Call-In Deliverance Sessions. I'm your host, Evangelist King, pastor at House Shalom, where we're simply building a peaceful house for God's glory. Remember, I make myself available every Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can call our deliverance conference line number 712-775-7031 and enter SS code 335950. Now, internationals, you too can join the call by visiting our website at houseshalom.org/deliverance. You will find the instructions on how to install free conference call mobile app on your Android or your Apple device. And that way, it will be at no cost or charge to you because it will simply be using your mobile Wi-Fi instead of your minutes. Praise the living God. Now, see, I have a call on the line that's 6095. I'm going to unmute you to see what your interest is if you are calling for a deliverance session. And now, I see, Campbell, you called back. But, Campbell, I am expecting Eddie to call me back today. So after I finish with 6095 and Eddie is online, then I'm going to answer his call, Campbell, and then I'll bring you on after Eddie, Campbell. That's if Eddie calls in, okay? So I'm going to unmute 6095. All right, 6095, you calling in for a session?
Yes, this is Shavonda. I had called last year, mm-hmm. And you prayed for me, and I'm calling back because I lost my sister in December the 9th of last year. She had just turned 42 years old. Mm-hmm. And since I lost her, I've been having like dreams about her. I needed prayer against negative, bad relationships with people, and I need God to shut doors that's open to the enemy and prayer against bad dreams and prayer for direction.
Okay, it's probably that spirit of grief that is attacking you, and then grief always open a door for spirit death. You know, mm-hmm. First Shavonda, what state are you calling from?
I'm in Virginia.
Virginia, mm-hmm. Yeah, that's who that is. So it's okay to grieve for our loved one, but the Lord have given us an allotted time, you know, okay, to grieve. But a continuous grief, that is dangerous. You open up the door for the spirit of death mm-hmm. to enter you. Okay, mm-hmm. The will of the Lord is done in your sister's life, so you're gonna have to just give it up to the Lord. You can't be worried about her. You know, worried about where she is. If she's in heaven, she's in hell. That's actually none of our affair. In other words, it's not our concern where a person is. You know, what's important is how we live our life on earth and how we live our life because others are looking at us. So you have to give that to your sister. We say your sister over to the Lord and just rejoice in him. Just rejoice in him. And that would close that door to that spirit of grief and also to that spirit death. Okay? So I'm going to pray for you, Shavonda. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I just thank you for your loving grace and mercy. I thank you, Father, for giving Shavonda peace in her heart, peace in her mind concerning her sister, Father. I ask you, Father, continue to give her revelation and understanding of your word. Give her a surety to know who she is in your son, Jesus, and also who Jesus is in her. And I thank you, Father, for your peace which surrounds her inside and out. And even amongst our environment, Father, I just thank you, Father, for giving her that peace in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, you stated that whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you'll bind and you'll loose in the heaven. So right now, I'm speaking to you, spirit death.
Yes.
You walk back home with Shavonda when she attended her sister's funeral, and the blood of Jesus commands you to leave. You get out. You get out of God's house. You get out of her house. you take grief and everything that belongs to you and get out. You pack all your loads and you get out in Jesus' name, because the blood of Jesus commands you to leave. Shavonda, I want you to go and open that door, and I want you to say, get out, spirit death, spirit grief, get out now in Jesus' mighty name.
Yes,
I want you to do that, Shavonda.
Yes.
That's an act of faith. Glory to your holy name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Lord, in Jesus' name.
Thank you. Yes.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
So go ahead. Tell them to get out. Open your mouth and say, get out in Jesus' name. Say, spirit death, get out. Spirit grief, get out.
Spirit of death, get out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, get out.
And death, get out in Jesus' name.
Death, get out in Jesus' name.
Amen. Now let me ask you, Sister Shavonda, did you bring her obituary home for a keepsake in your house?
Actually, I did not have one. No.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, I didn't get one.
So
I had
so
one,
you,
but I gave it to someone.
So in other words, Shavonda, you did get one, but you ended up giving somebody one.
Yes.
So because of that act, you got one. Because of that, even though you gave it away, but it still was an act that you committed. You got it, and your intention was to bring it home.
Yes.
So all the devil needed was that act. So when you went home, that spirit death, along with spirit grief, walked right home along with you.
Okay.
So such things you don't want to bring home, nothing like that, and from a frontal road that remind you of your loved one death, because you're bringing home spirit grief and you're bringing home spirit death along with you. God gave you good memories of your sister, and that's what you dwell on, are those good memories. You don't need no physical object to remind you of the happy times that God has given you with your sister. The Lord had given you those good memories. And you praise and you thank the Lord for those good memories. But anything that is tied to her death, her funeral, you do not bring it back home. You don't even desire to bring it back home, because just the thought of it, even though physically you never bring it home, but just the thought of it, that's all the devil needs. It's all the devil needs. Because what the enemy wanted to do, Shabbat, he wanted to take you out too. That's why that grief did it work to open the door for spirit death to eventually take you out too. But the devil is a lie. So praise his holy name.
And it's been a lot of negative people coming, a lot of different people was troubling my spirit. And I'm, ask God to shut those doors. And it's just been so much going on, but I still keep my faith in God.
Amen. That's exactly what you do now, okay? Continue to think on the goodness of God and just praise him and the good memories that he did give you in reference to your sister. That is what you dwell on, those good memories. And as you dwell on those good memories, you give that praise and glory back to the Lord, because God, all goodness comes from him. And that's how a person will beat the spirit grief and spirit death whenever their loved one dies. And then when you dream or when you go to sleep, you happen to see your sister, that is not your sister. It's a demon spirit trying to get into your life. You rebuke it in Jesus' name. You rebuke it in Jesus' name.
Okay.
Yeah, that is not your sister, because there's a lot of God's children that is communicating with demons because their loved one have died, and the demon take on the parents of their loved one, and they actually think they're communicating, talking to their loved one. Their children who lost their parent, and the devil is masquerading as their parent in their dreams, and once they receive these demons in the dreams, then they'll make known to themselves to the child in the physical, and the child think they communicating with their father, with their mother, with the demon spirit, and they end up becoming demonized, and a lot of them end up killing themselves because they say they want to go where their parent is, want to go where their loved one is. So you rebuke it. That is not the Lord. That's not the Lord. Okay. And people come around you talking about your sister. They don't talk about the good memories. The good memories, you tell them, you know what? I don't care to hear about that. If you want to talk about the good memories, I would be glad to loan you my hearing. But if you're not talking about the good memories where God gets the glory, I cannot loan you my hearing. I have to protect my hearing because it's going to fit what's in my heart.
Okay. And
that's what you do. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
All right. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, still, sister.
All right. Be blessed.
Okay. You too. Bye-bye. Praise God. Okay, so I see Ed haven't come on, so I'm going to give Campbell about 5 or 10 minutes, and then I would bring, that's if Eddie doesn't come online, I'll bring 1954 on the line. Okay. Okay, Campbell.
Well, hi, Sister King.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, what's going on? I replied to your email.
Let me check my email, yeah. But yesterday after you prayed over me, I could feel this pressure wrapped around my head. I could feel pressure on my forehead and the size of my head, but what's more present on my forehead. So I prayed against it, and the moment I prayed against it, I felt these two bangs, like, I'm not sure if it's bangs or whatnot, but I felt this thing pierce my heart, and then my heart started having pain again.
And that's why you still have to rebuke it. Remember that, Campbell, these spirits are not in you. They're on the outside, and what they're trying to do, they're trying to get back in. Now, I tell you, it's going to be a spiritual battle because of what your father, who you are living with, is involved. He's a voodoo priest. So that battle is going to be there, but God wants you to lean on your faith in his word. You have to rebuke these spirits. They are liars. They are not in you. They're trying to get back in you. And so what they're going to end up doing, they're going to end up doing things to you that you are familiar with. And because you're familiar with it, your mind tells you that they are in you because you are familiar with that when it's a lie, because God has already delivered you. They're trying to get back in. They're trying to get you to give up your faith and trust in believing that God had delivered you from them on the inside. See, they are all about you on the outside, again, because of what your father, I mean, he got that evil altar set up in the house in 2 rooms. He got an evil altar set up in the house. So that's those spirits' domain, okay? So they're always going to be there. But they're going to try it again. They want to cripple your and hinder your faith in believing that God set you free so that you can open the door to let them back in where they want to be. They prefer being on the inside of a person, of a human host. They don't like dwelling in things. Their aim is to dwell in human beings. So they want to dwell in you. But you're going to have to continue to keep your faith in God and rebuke them and be praising and thanking God for setting you free. From this day forth, Cameron, no longer will you say what you are feeling. Don't speak about what you're feeling, okay? You speak about what Jesus Christ has done for you. You rebuke that feeling. Lord said, rebuke that feeling, because it's not him who's giving you that feeling. It's those spirits on the outside. So you rebuke that feeling, but with your mouth you open up and you give praise to God and adoration to God for setting you totally free. Now you're going to have to do this because it's going to be a great battle because of where you are. You are in another man's house, and that man worships Satan. He has his evil altar, so those spirits are there on the outside. But remember, they're not in you. So it's going to be this battle, and that's what you're going to have to do. So you have to use your mouth to speak blessing, as the Lord told you yesterday. Continue to use your mouth to speak blessing. Never speak what you feel. You rebuke what you feel, and you only speak what Jesus has done for you, which is he set you totally free. Now, as you continue to do that, Campbell, your faith in God will grow stronger and stronger, and then you will experience less of those devils attacking you. Okay?
Okay.
So that's gonna come in time according to your faith. So as you continue to open your mouth, speak what Jesus has done for you instead of speaking your feeling, your faith in him will get stronger and stronger. And next thing you know, as your faith grows stronger and stronger, you will begin to less experience those feelings that you're getting from the devil. See, right now, because they have been attacking you for so long, Campbell, you have faith in that. You have faith in that. So that's why it's so easy for you to feel it. Because even right now, I'm talking, demons are all around me trying to get to me, trying to attack me, but I don't feel them. Why? Because my faith in God is so strong that I don't feel them. Because I magnified the Lord. Now, before that, that was totally different. So that's what you're going to have to do as well. Okay? Again, it's a battle. Okay?
All right, I will.
Yeah, and remember who's with you. Jesus himself is with you, Campbell. He is with you always. The Holy Spirit is with you. Whenever you do feel those demons around you, you call on the Holy Spirit. Say, Holy Ghost, fire. Consume them. Consume darkness. Consume darkness. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn. Burn them. Burn them. And the Holy Spirit would do that, and next thing you know, those devils are running back into those rooms and jumping into those evil altars that's set up in those rooms. That's what you do. Okay?
All right.
All right?
Thank you.
Your holy name. You're welcome. Stay blessed. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. I had to answer him. He got delivered from yesterday from voodoo. He's a Haitian. God delivered him from voodoo. His father and parents are into voodoo, and they got those evil altars in the house. And he's a young 20-year-old, and he needs that encouragement. So I had to bring him on, as the Holy Spirit had told me to do. So I'm going to now bring on, because Eddie still haven't came. He probably come shortly. So I'm going to bring on 1954. That name looks familiar, but I'm not for sure. Okay, 1954. Now, have I ministered to you before?
No. This is
okay.
How are you?
I'm fine. Your first name again?
Barbara.
And what state you calling from?
California.
California. Okay, now, I have never ministered to you before?
No, ma'am.
Okay, all right. So, Barbara, how do you find out about me?
One of my dear friends got in touch with you, and she was so impressed, and she went. You took her to do deliverance, and she's just been praising you. And I said, well, okay, but the enemy has been, like, keeping me from remembering to call at 11. So,
it is 11 in California time.
For my time, right.
Yeah.
And I looked at the clock. I was taking care of some business, and when I looked at the clock, I said, oh, my God, it's 11:05, and I was so surprised that I got a chance to get through.
Amen.
I've been with the encouragement that you've been given to the people that you minister to, is, you know, and that's what we need.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be encouraged.
Mm-hmm.
We really need to be encouraged. So I was.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. So Barbara, what exactly you are expecting the Lord Himself to do in your life right now?
You know, I have been so discouraged with my Heavenly Father for His things that I have, you know, petitioned for years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So at this point, the only thing I'm really, I've been in ministry over 20 years, so.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord has just gifted me the gift of prophecy. And mm-hmm. so I'm feel more comfortable in ministering. But I've really, I just don't want to do ministry. I've never have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, from the time God called me, I never wanted to do ministry, and I never understood why. It's just like a bad taste in my mouth. Because I know I have to please the Father, but I don't do it because I love it too. You know how
mm-hmm.
you love your ministry, but I can't say that about mine.
Mm-hmm. You know, let me tell you why you can't say that.
Ma'am?
Do you want me to tell you why you cannot say it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You have a spirit husband. That spirit husband is the one who really has rejected the call of God on your life. His role in darkness to hinder your destiny in Him. So it's actually that spirit husband in you that is blocking your joy, blocking your happiness, and fulfilling the Father's will in your life. Now, even though you've been in ministry 20 years, and I have ministered to people been in ministry 30 and 40 years, but they've never been truly delivered. So, Barbara, you've never been truly delivered, okay? God's going to deliver you today.
Thank you.
Now, even though you have repented of your wrongdoing, confessed and repented, and God has forgiven you, but there's never been a Lord-appointed servant who took their authority in Jesus Christ to confront the strong man, the spirit husband, the strong man that's in your life. Like, I don't know if you've ever seen a National Geographic movies where of a gorilla who has his harem of female gorillas or apes, whatever you call them, and he know he's in charge. He's a man, so he just stand up with his chest bolted out, and he just take his two hands, ball up his fist, and beat his chest because he know he's the strong man of the house. See, that's right. What a spirit spouse feels like. They the strong man of the house. No one can dethrone me, but Jesus Christ can. And this spirit, it was espoused to you, just like in the natural, you know, when we get married, we are espoused to our partner. Well, this spirit was espoused to you, and how it became espoused to you, Barbara, there was a childhood molestation that took place in your life. Now, that don't necessarily mean a penetration, but molestation on a more simple term meaning is that you came into the knowledge of sex as a child, and it really wasn't your time because it's a time for all things. But when a child comes to knowledge of sex before their time, that is known as a molestation. So your eyes saw something concerning sex that you shouldn't have seen, or your ears heard something, or your hands touched something.
Okay.
So Holy Spirit, bring that memory back to Barbara. You heard something, or you saw something, or you touched something. Now, as far as touching something, an example is a lot of times as little children, you play mom and dad games with other little children. Mm-hmm. And a little boy may have liked you, and he touched you, and that touch really was an inappropriate touch. It was a touch of love. It just wasn't an ordinary friendly touch. Well, that's molestation, and that meant that little boy got molested as well. Now, a lot of times when your eyes see something, the child end up maybe seeing pornography or maybe see mom and dad or someone else having sex. Or if it's the ears involved, they may have heard someone having sex. Rather, it was the parent or neighbors or someone else, or rather it was on TV. Mm-hmm. Now, all of that is considered to be molestation. So that's when you was espoused to the spirit, is during the time of a childhood molestation. So what has the Holy Spirit brought to your remembrance?
Basically, I don't even kind of remember my childhood. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember playing with my next door neighbors. It mm-hmm. was a lot of. I was the only child, so I played a mm-hmm. lot with neighbors.
Mm-hmm. So you played with the next door neighbor. Do you remember what type of games that you played?
Oh, God. We did hide and seek and just, that's about the only thing I can remember, hide and seek and things like that. I mean, you know, children just running and playing, so.
Mm-hmm. You don't remember another child touching you? Now, not just grabbing onto you, touching, just blatantly touching you, but you don't remember another child just grabbing on you.
If I did, I just never thought of. I don't know.
Okay. Let me ask you this, Barbara. Now, have you ever masturbated?
Yes.
Okay. What age were you when you masturbated?
Oh, I was an adult. maybe.
So you had sex before marriage?
Yes.
Did the masturbation come after the sex before marriage or before?
Oh, in my late years, I never even knew anything about masturbation till late. You know, when I got in my late 20s and started reading books and things like that.
Okay. So did you have sex outside of marriage before you started masturbating, or masturbated first?
I had just graduated high school. I was, 18 when I first, my first encounter with sex, I was 18.
Okay. So did you, that was your first time. Now, before that time, you never desired to be with a guy sexually before you were with this guy.
I had boyfriends, but sexually, I didn't even sex.
Okay, hold it. Okay, you had boyfriend. Did how old were you when you had your first boyfriend?
My mom started letting me date when I was 15.
Now, 15, now you two didn't engage in sexual intercourse, but did you two kiss? Did you kiss?
Repeat that again, please.
Okay, so at 15, you and this guy didn't engage yourself into sexual intercourse. You did not have sexual intercourse.
That's something I was really blessed with all my teen years. No boy never forced him for me anything.
Okay. Right, but my question is: did you two kiss?
Kiss,
yeah.
I'm sure we probably did.
Yeah, okay. The reason I'm asking these questions, Barbara, is because we're trying to get to the root, because that spirit was already in you. Spirit was in you, because even at 15, you kissing that boy shows me that spirit hug was already in you, because even at 15. Person don't have no business dating, don't have no business kissing, because it leads to other things. You know, a lot of times people think a kiss is harmless. A kiss is not harmless. It's not, even though you didn't engage in sexual, you know, intercourse, still, according to the law, you were still sinning. That's sin, because that was not your husband. And when you do that kissing, that's a sign that that spirit snake, along with spirit husband, Lord said, a spirit snake was also in you. So what made you want to have a boyfriend at 15? At 15, do you have other sisters who maybe had boyfriends?
I'm an only child.
So you are only child. Did you watch movies, love movies on television, romance movies on television? Something made you want to have a boyfriend at 15.
I liked what I saw.
That spirit was in you. Spirit husband was in you. Spirit husband and spirit snake, which is love, was already in you at age of 15, and that is a type of molestation. But what I'm trying to get to is, how did this thing get into you?
That's what I would like to know.
Something happened where this thing entered you. That's why at 15 you want a boyfriend, you want a kiss, you like what you saw. That's because that lust, that spirit snake, which is lust, will look him through your eyes.
Okay.
So, again, did you watch movies concerning romance?
God, it wasn't that much on in the 50s, late 60s. Let's see, I was like 15.
Most
movies that were out, you know, way back then, they didn't really show sex like they do now. So
right, true. Were you living with both your mother and your biological father?
No. I live with my mother, my grandmother, and my grandfather.
Your mother, your grandmother, grandfather. Now, did your mother have different boyfriends coming to the house?
They didn't play that. No, no. I was like, I may have been like maybe 15 or so older when my mother started dating and had someone. I wasn't allowed to be up front when she had company. She had a
You didn't have to be. You don't have to be. You don't have to be. See, the parent is the spiritual covering for their children. Okay. And the children are underage, they are spiritual covering. So if the parent reject God, then they don't have that spiritual covering. Okay? So if the parent don't have that spiritual covering, the child don't have that spiritual covering. So this is what more than likely what happened. When your mother started dating, even though you were staying with your grandmother, your grandfather, your mother all together, and you was allowed to be around your mother and her boyfriend, that don't matter, because we're talking about spiritual here, because you didn't have a spiritual covering. So if your mother connected herself with a man who was full of lust and she didn't know it, do you not know, because she connected her soul, which is her mind, her will, emotion, to that man, that spirit of lust in that man would transfer to your mother, to you, because you under her covering.
Right, I believe that, yes, okay.
And that is a molestation. See, a lot of people don't think that's a molestation. They always think of a physical act, a child, you know, of being penetrated. No, spiritually speaking, no.
Okay.
So actually, that's how this spirit husband attached itself in your life. So when you got 15, you know, your eyes started wandering, and you found this, you know, found a little boy that you like. You know, you like what you just went on, told the truth. I like what I saw.
I saw.
You see, that's lust. That's lust. So that means that spirit snake was in you, because that is lust looking out through the window of your eye. You know, later on, as you got older, then it had you to commit the physical acts. You already committed the spiritual act.
Okay.
That's why Lord said the person who is without sin, throw the first stone. No mm-hmm. one could throw it, because even though they hadn't touched the adulterous woman physically, but spiritually, they already committed the act.
Okay.
You see, they had done it in the spirit realm. You see, because you have a lot of virgins, people who are virgin, they actually never had physical intercourse with a human being, but spiritually, they are not a virgin. I ministered to a lot of physical virgins, but they was not a spiritual virgin. And God, I was like, you're not a virgin at all, you see, because even though they never had sex with a human being, they had sex with that spirit being.
Okay.
So, Barbara, if no one, if a non-appointed servant has never confronted this gorilla, you know, so when I say gorilla, have you actually seen on television the gorilla beating his chest? Because it's in charge, it's in control of all the female gorillas and the little gorillas that is under him.
Correct.
They just beat their chest like King Kong. We'll say King Kong. Yeah. That's how the spirit husband is. And if a non-appointed servant of God never approached this spirit husband and commanded to come out of your mind, your will, your emotion, because that's why you can't even rejoice in the work that God gave you to do. And
is
in your body. Yeah.
Is that also why it's taken so long for my husband, well, a husband to come to me too?
Yeah, because a lot of times, sometimes these spirit spouses won't allow human beings to marry. And then when they do allow human beings to marry, they will make sure they marry the wrong person. They can't choose the right person, but they end up giving them the wrong person. That's why you see so much divorce and remarriage in the church.
Yeah.
That's why so many divorce and remarry, okay?
Uh-huh.
They just hinder, because their aim is to get you to fall out with God. They blame God for your problem. They blame God for your troubles. That's their aim,
to blame God,
you know.
No, but I better.
God
yeah.
haven't answered me yet. I haven't answered me yet. When they actually are the problem, But God gonna set you totally free. Now, because when you first came to Jesus Christ, it was just only your spirit that was birthed and born into the family of God. But you had the same soul, which is mind, will, emotions, and body. And that's where God delegated his authority to his body on earth to cast devils out of the soul and out of the body. He said, whatsoever you bind and loose on earth, I will bind and loose in the heaven. So he wanted you to know all this information, Bobby, so your eyes can be open to truth, and so you will see and know what really happened and what really has been the cause of your problems.
Oh, yes, Lord.
And now you can help others to get others set free as well. Okay? So I'm going to pray for you, Barbara, and then I'm going to speak this disconnection, okay?
Thank you.
Amen. So, Father, in Jesus' name, again, thank you for this opportunity to minister your love and grace and mercy to your daughter, Barbara. Father, it's her time to go forth in the power of your might and to be joyful and glad about doing your will on this earth, Father. Father, I ask you to continue to give her more wisdom, revelation, understanding of who she is in your son Jesus, and also who Jesus is in her. Thank you, Father, for keeping her, sealing her with your spirit, Father, keeping her to that day of redemption. Father, I speak concerning doors of which the enemy closed off the barber, and it's your will that those doors be open. I speak my thoughts in Jesus' name, and I open every door that is your will to be open. And then there are doors that the enemy opened that was not your will. I also take my thoughts in Jesus' name to close every door that the enemy opened that was not your will to be opened. And I seal those doors in and with the blood of Jesus, never ever to be opened or reopened again. I thank you, Father, for your loving grace, your compassion, and your mercy. Thank you, Father, for setting this captive totally free so Barbara can truthfully, spiritually worship you, where she can be glad and be full of joy in doing your will, Father. And I thank you, Father, that after her deliverance, Father, I thank you for baptizing her with your spirit, Father. Filling her to overflow with your spirit. Empower her with your spirit, Father, to do and carry out your will on this earth, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. And Father, we want to thank you for your presence today on this conference line, because you are always with us. You said whenever we come together in your son's name, Jesus Christ, you are right here with us. And you also said, whatever we bind and loose on this earth that is your will, you will do the same in the heavenly. So right now, I'm going to take authority in Jesus' name, and Spirit Alpha, I command you, in the name of Jesus, I command you to pack your load. You gather all your things and you get out of God's house. Get out of God's house. You get out of her mind. You get out of her will. You get out of her emotion. And you get out of her body now. Get out in Jesus' name. For the blood of Jesus commands and commanded you to loose her. Loose her and let her go. Let her go. Come out. You hear me? We may have been disconnected physically, but you heard me, and I command you in the mighty name of Jesus to loose her and to let her go. Let her go. Cut out her mind. Cut out her mind. Loose her mind. Loose her mind. Loose her mind. You come out of her will. Cut out her emotions. Take your things, get out of her emotion, and you come out of her body. Holy Ghost, I call upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. I call upon you to search and destroy darkness. They are dominantly hiding and lurking in Barbara's mind. Burn every spirit in her mind that exalts and lifts themselves against the knowledge of God and set them all ablaze. So ablaze, Holy Ghost, burn by your mighty fire in Jesus' mighty name. Just ransack her mind by your fire. Wash her mind. Clean her mind. Rinse her mind. Redeem her mind. Purify her mind. And baptize her mind in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, set ablaze in her will. Burn every spirit in her will that exalts and lifts themselves against the knowledge of God and set them all ablaze. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn by your mighty fire. Just ransackle her will by your mighty fire. Wash her will. Rinse her will. clean, redeem, and purify, and baptize her will in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, celebrate her emotion. Burn every spirit in her emotion that exalts and lifts themselves against the knowledge of God. Set them all ablaze. Burn every spirit in her emotion. They don't move, walk, act, nor react like you. They don't even talk like you. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set ablaze darkness. They are dormantly hiding and even lurking and running up and down right now in her body. Set her body ablaze. Burn, burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, Holy Ghost. Burn those snakes in her eyes. Burn snakes in her eyes. Burn every spirit that comes up and look out through the window of her eyes. Set them all ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn around her eyes, in front, behind, even the side of her eyes. Burn, Holy Ghost. Just ransack her eyes by your mighty fire. Wash her eyes. Clean her eyes. Rinse and purify, redeem, and baptize her eyes in and with the blood of Jesus. Rinse her eyes in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, even set her mouth ablaze. Burn darkness that is having in her mouth. Burn, Holy Ghost, just ransack her mouth by your mighty fire. Wash her mouth. Rinse, clean, redeem, and purify her mouth in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her nostrils ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn darkness that's hiding in her nostril. Burn by your mighty fire. Just rinse her nostrils. Clean, redeem, and purify and baptize her nostrils in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her ears ablaze by your mighty fire. Just ransack her ears by your mighty fire. Wash her ears, rinse her ears, clean her ears, purify her ears, redeem her ears, and baptize her ears in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her throat ablaze by your mighty fire. Burn all manner of spirits that are even hiding in her throat. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' mighty name. Wash her throat. Clean her throat. Redeem her throat. Purify her throat and rinse and baptize her throat in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her belly ablaze by your mighty fire. Burn all manner of spirits that are deeply hiding deep down in her belly. Set her belly ablaze. Set her belly ablaze. Burn those snakes in her belly. Burn their ears. Burn all kind of spirits that is in her belly. They're like animal, insect, sea creature, and takes on human appearances. Burn them all. Burn them all. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn, Holy Ghost. Just wash her belly. Rinse, clean, redeem, and purify, and baptize her belly in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her uterus ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn, burn, Holy Ghost. Set her fallopian tubes ablaze. Set her womb ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn in Jesus' name. Wash those organs by your holy fire. Just baptize them in and with the blood of Jesus. Rinse and clean and purify and redeem them in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, even set her rectum ablaze. Set ablaze all manner of spirits that is living dormantly in her rectum. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn, 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 burn by your mighty fire. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, purify, and baptize her rectum in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her vagina ablaze by your mighty fire. Burn, Holy Ghost, burn all manner of spirit that is dormantly hiding it. Hiding right now, even in her vagina. Set them ablaze by your mighty fire in Jesus' name. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, and purify and baptize her vagina in and with the blood of Jesus in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, celebrate. Spirits that attach yourself on her bed. Burn up and down her bed. Burn up and down her bed. Burn up and down her breath. Burn up and down her chest. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn up and down her arms, her lips. Burn those rings on her fingers. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn that necklace around her neck. Burn that crown on her head. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every mark that was made known or unknown on her body, set those months ablaze by your mighty fire. Burn all manner of image that been pierced on and in her body. Set them all ablaze in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire, wash her body. Wash her body. Clean her body. Purify her body. Redeem her body. Rinse her body and baptize her body in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take the seals of God. I cut and detach his barber from that ungodly covenant of family of idolatry and witchcraft, because the blood of Jesus has forgiven her and her ancestors. The blood of Jesus forgave them of their iniquity. The blood of Jesus separate her and detaches her from you. By faith in Jesus' name, I detach Barbara from that ungodly marriage in the spirit realm. I disconnect her. I disconnect her from that evil spirit husband. I even disconnect her from that evil spirit wife and all those evil spirit children. I disconnect her from that entire evil spirit family. I disconnect her from every relationship in the spirit realm that the Father did not connect her to. I disconnect, because the blood of Jesus disconnects and set her free. Even in this natural realm, every relationship the Father did not connect her to, I disconnect her, because the blood of Jesus disconnect her in Jesus' mighty name. Barbara, in Jesus' name, be totally free. Be totally free to serve the Lord thy God in spirit and truth. You be totally free in your mind. Be totally free in your mind. You be totally free in your will. You be totally free in your emotions. Be totally free in your dreams, in your vision, your business, your affairs. And you be totally free in your body to serve and worship the Lord. In him only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Father, fill Barbara to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind to overflow. Fill her will to overflow. Fill her emotions to overflow. Fill her dreams, her vision, her business affairs to overflow with your spirit. And fill her body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for dispatching your angels in the heavenly realm and gathering every spirit that was not of you and sending them where you desire to send them in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, I also pray for my sister's house. Holy Spirit, go at Barbara's house right now. Search and destroy all darkness hiding places. Go in every corner, crack, and crevice of her house and destroy darkness. Go in every bedroom and destroy darkness that hovers around the bed, under the bed, over the bed, the front, the foot of the bed, on top of the bed, even between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy darkness. Go in every closet and destroy darkness. Go in every closed space and destroy darkness. Go between the walls and destroy darkness. Don't leave no area untouched in her house. In Jesus' name, destroy darkness in Jesus' mighty name. Destroy the objects that are there, that they are attached to. Destroy those evil objects in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire, go even outside the house. Destroy darkness that hovers around the house, over and under the house, even around the sides of the house, and destroy darkness. Holy Ghost, fire, destroy objects that was planted under the earth in her name and her family name. Destroy those evil objects that were planted under the earth. Destroy those evil objects that were thrown on top of the earth. Destroy in Jesus' name. Destroy evil objects that were thrown in the rivers, in the water. Destroy in Jesus' name. Destroy all colors and contracts that was written under the earth. Destroy those evil covenant contracts that were written under the earth in her name, her family name. Destroy all evil covenant contracts that was written on top of the earth. Destroy, Holy Ghost, destroy those covenant contracts that was written in her name, her family name. Even evil objects and even contracts and covenants that was written up in the water in her name and her family name, destroy by your mighty fire in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for filling Barbara with your spirit, placing her in a fiery ring of hot protection. And thank you for the angels linking themselves around her, protecting her continually 24/7. Father, we give you praise and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Barbara?
Yes. Would you believe I got disconnected from you
three times? Three times. Yeah, three times. That was Spirit Husband. That was that gorilla.
Yeah. It's just like you were praying. And I was like, where did he go? Hello, hello. Then I called back in a few minutes and cut off again.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know, every time you came online, I had to stop. Because the first time a spirit did that to me, the Lord said, don't stop. Keep praying fire prayer. Even though you are disconnected from the human being, there's no distance in the spirit realm, and those demons are still hearing. Besides, that's who you're talking to. You're not talking to the human being anyway. You're talking to those spirit beings. They hear you. He said it's a matter of time that the human being will reconnect, but you don't stop. And that's why I don't stop. I keep on. So Lord told me to take notice of you, so whenever you come back on, I'll just unmute you because I knew who it was.
Oh,
you are totally free. I knew who it was. You are totally free. You're free, Barbara. Praise him. Thank him. Praise him and thank him. And tell the Father that you look forward to doing his will. It's not your will be done, just like our Savior Jesus Christ said. It's not our will, but it's his will to be done in our life. That's the purpose of our existence, is to fulfill his will and purpose in our life. So you say, thank you, Father, for freeing me. My mind is free. Devil's not no longer living in my mind. They're not there, Father. You snatched them out. They're not living in my will. You snatched them out. They're not living no more in my emotion. You snatched them out. They're not living in my body. You snatched them out. Now I am totally free to truthfully, spiritually worship you, because you stated in your word that you look for true worshipers. And I truly am a true worshiper now. And I hold my hands up and praise you and magnify you. And let your will be done in my life. And Father, your joy is my joy. Praise the living God. And that's what you tell your Heavenly Father. You go on and do your Father's business. As far as a husband, that's, give that concern. That's a care. That's a care, Barbara. So you have to cast that care on Jesus. So here, Jesus, I'm giving you that care. I refuse to carry this care. Here, you know how to handle it, because you know what to do and when to do it. I'm keeping my mind, my affection stayed on you, so my heart can remain in perfect peace. And that's what you do, Bob. Okay?
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Amen. So now, even though we got disconnected three times, did the Father allow you to experience anything as I was praying?
No. It's like every time I tried to just center myself and listen, I would get cut off. And then
And Lord, just tell me why the enemy did that, because the enemy trying to cripple your faith. He figured, well, if she don't experience anything, she don't feel nothing, then I can get her to either believe that she's not set free because she didn't feel anything. Now, remember, now you are a minister. You know what the word told us, that we live by faith.
Oh, yeah.
Anything that's not of faith is sin, and sin will open the door for the devil. So if you don't receive what God done for you by faith, then that's sin, and then no devil will come right back. That gorilla is going to come right back into you. And it'll bring another gorilla that's more powerful than it. Matter of fact, seven of them. You don't want that to happen. So you receive what God done by faith. You say, thank you, Jesus. Even though I didn't feel nothing because I kept being disconnected, I said, but I receive by faith. I know you set me free, because you do not lie. You told us, whatever we bind and loose on this earth, that is your will that I be free. You told us you would do it. And I believe your word. I'm not walking by my feelings. I'm walking by my faith in your word alone. So glory be to your holy name. I am free. And then that devil would get that message.
Do you mind if I call on your days that you're on the phone and just listen to you?
Well, no, I don't. Okay, now since you told me, so whenever you come up, then I know that you called to listen. As a matter of fact, let me make a note on your caller ID. Hold up.
Okay.
I'll make a note here on your caller ID so that when you call, then I know that's the
person. The reason why I'm asking is because I was many years ago, I was prophesied that I was going to have a deliverance ministry. Well, I've been running from that ministry forever.
Well, that's good because you won't deliver. Look at it on the good side.
Deliverance. I love it. That's why I was sad when I kept getting cut off. But I like going through deliverance.
God wants you to walk by your faith. You got to go by faith. As a matter of fact, when casting out spirits, we have to go by faith. You can't go by what you hear or see, because they will fool you. They will fool you. They will manifest and talk to you and act like they're gone. But you ain't doing this thing by faith. Soon as that person walk out the door, them devils jump right back in them.
Amen.
But if you cast them out by faith, then they know they got to go. So you have this a work that you have to do by faith.
Amen.
Okay? You don't go by how they manifest. They will fool you. They will fool you big time. Big time they will. But it's by faith in God's word that you know that they are, that the Father cast them out in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Okay?
Yes. Oh, yes. I've been around ministers on through myself, so but no one has ever mentioned a spirit husband.
Yeah, that's what that thing was. Yeah, because remember now, as a child, your mother was your covering. Okay, so if she rejected God, wasn't serving the Lord like she should, then that means that God was not her covering. So you didn't have a spiritual covering. So whatever she let in the house, which is her body, in her soul. It also transferred into you. So if she dated guys who was ungodly, spirit of lust, then that lust traveled from that guy to her to you. So that's why I hear you clearly say, he looked good to me. That means that was lust in the eyes.
Oh, yeah.
And that's molestation.
Yeah. It's like even through my lifetime, I've only been attracted to lighter-skinned men.
They prefer lighter-skinned men now.
I prefer light.
Preference. Them devils have a preference.
And even at this age, I prefer white men or any other race other than black.
Mm-mm. No. Well, you are totally free. You prefer a God man. And God man is who God sent. It don't matter. Don't matter of the color of his skin, as long as God sent him and he's full
Thank
of
you.
The
I'm
Holy
well.
Ghost and fire. Now, what matters how he looks on the inside, not outside, but the inside. So you wait on God.
I ain't going nowhere. Look, I've been waiting for my daddy for too long to know. Whenever he get ready, it'll come. I ain't even worried.
Amen. Okay, but so I got your caller ID as Barbara, California, listening. So that way it'll let me know that you're calling in and listening, because the Holy Spirit wants to teach you. He's gonna teach you some things.
Yes, I want to listen to you.
Okay.
What is your first name? I'm sorry.
Now my first name is Terry, Terry. But ministry-wise, Evangelist King, because I'm functioning as Evangelist King.
K-I-N-G?
But on the K-I-N-G. But a personal note is Terry.
Okay. No problem. Are you a prophetess or apostle?
Well, Lord told me I was an evangelist, but what the Holy Spirit does is as he used me as he will, as he sees fit, as he will. So sometimes he have me function in the office of a prophet, an apostle of one sense, pastor, teacher, evangelist. It's as the Holy Spirit will. So I'm just a servant of God.
I'm just
a servant of God, his servant.
Yeah. People
and
are
one.
Disciples. I just asked. It wasn't.
Yeah.
No,
but most everybody know me as Evangelist King. That's what I post as Evangelist King. Okay?
Thank you.
All right, Sister Barbara.
Thank you. And do you mind if I listen to your next caller?
Oh, that's fine. You can stay on. Because I think this is Shamar. This is this young man. He's Eddie called yesterday. Eddie's 14. He wanted deliverance, but his father ran him off the phone. So just keep Eddie and his parents in prayer. Pray for his parent, because they need to submit their life to the Lord.
Right.
Okay. So you can just agree with me as the Lord deliver.
Oh, yes.
Our little brother Eddie. So I'm going to mute you and bring Eddie on.
Fine.
Okay?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. All right, Shamar. Is Eddie there? Shamar.
Hello?
Is Eddie there?
No, he keeps thinking that he's going to be in this, and sorry for my heavy breathing, because I just got home from walking, but he keeps thinking that he's going to be in disobedience to his parents.
Oh, that's that demon telling him that. That's
I know.
That spirit wife telling him that. Don't want him to get delivered.
I'm trying.
Oh. That is that demon spirit telling him he's going to be in disobedience to his parents. And when he acts in disobedience to God, he asked God to deliver him from porno and masturbation. And God pointed him the way, because he is of age to decide which way he want to go. And by him agreeing to obey his parents, he actually disobeying God.
That's what I told him that.
Yeah. Show him the scripture. Show the scripture where Jesus himself said that unless we're willing to give up mother, father, remember that scripture, mother, father, sister, brother, mm-hmm. children, and follow him, if we don't do that, then we don't have no right to be called his disciple. You need to show him that scripture.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Show him that scripture. We cannot put nobody ahead of God. The Lord told children to obey their parents in the Lord. Show him that scripture. Obey your parents in the Lord.
I told him that too. And
yeah,
I also was in the temple at 12 years old teaching and preaching.
Right. There you go, baby. That's why I tell children that in order for them to request a deliverance session without their parents, they have to be at least 12. If they are under 12, then they must be accompanied with their parent. But if they're 12 or older, they don't have to be accompanied with their parent because they are of age.
Mm-hmm. We were talking in class about how he was going to get delivered, and those spirits are just keep lying to him.
Mm-hmm. And he was so excited about them spirits convinced him
yep.
that he would be in disobedience to his parents. You know, those parents do wives like that. They do wives like that, rest to their husband. And that's why you have a lot of wives who disobey God because the devil's in their husband, because the devil would tell them, don't script tell you that you're supposed to obey your husband. Yeah, in the Lord. In the Lord. Right now, Ananias and Sapphira, a husband-wife team, is in hell because they lied to the Holy Ghost and they was in agreement together. And Peter first confronted the husband, and he lied. And next thing you know, he fell dead. Then the wife came a couple hours later looking for her husband. Peter asked her. She told the same lie, and then she fell dead. So the wife came to say, in the Lord. The same thing with children. You know, when I was coming up, whenever my parent or grown up would tell me do something wrong, and I knew it was against what God said, I didn't do it. I said, no, that's wrong. I cannot do that. You can call me a disobedient child. I said, well, you have to call me that because I'm not going to do it because you want me to do something that is wrong in the eyes of God. I'm going to have to suffer for that. You see?
And I also told him about how, when I was telling him about how you're supposed to obey your parents in the Lord, I was telling him about how, if your parents wanted you to rob a bank, would you do it? Because the scriptures, God said in his word, thou shalt not steal.
And what did he say then?
He said, yeah. He was in agreement. I don't know. Those spirits are just...
So I wonder if his father said something to him after he got off the phone. That devil through his father said something to him after he got off the phone when his father told him to get off the phone.
I don't know. He keeps bringing up, his dad might try to sever our relationship. And
oh, man. See, he loved his father more than he loved God.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the Lord just said. See, that was a test for him. So the Lord tests him, let him see that he that his the love for his father is more than the love for God.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have to be willing, we have to be willing to give up our loved ones, husband, mm-hmm. wife, son, daughter, mom, dad, cousin, don't matter who. We must be willing to give up. And like the Lord said, no one has given up mother, father, sister, brother, or family member, and God has not blessed them and has not replaced them. He said, no one. So he actually showed God. Next time you see him, like tomorrow at school, you say him, the Evangel King said that the Lord said, you showed him that you that the love for your father is greater than your love for him.
And Lord, if that's the funny thing about it is his father is supposed to be a deacon in the church.
And he's supposed to be a deacon in church, and he watched pornography.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of deacons who watch pornography. But yet still in church now, you think they were mighty men, women of God, but they are they masturbate and in pornography.
And I told him this was probably a test for both of us.
Yeah.
It was probably from the Lord for both of us.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he showed God. And that young man, I mean, he out of his mouth yesterday, he said he asked the Lord to set him free.
Mm-hmm.
Because God connected him with you and the youth. Because God set you free from that very same thing that he's seeking God to set him free from. And then he mm-hmm. called. He was so excited. Even after he hung up, so excited. And the devil knew he was about to lose one. He knew he was about to lose that little boy. He
mm-hmm.
knew that. But if Eddie don't come and get delivered and he continue life, his daddy one day is going to wish he gotten delivered because he's going to break his heart.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to break his heart. Well, you done your part, Shamar. You done your part. So you, God said that he's not going to hold you responsible. You've done your part. Your hands is clean of that affair. You've done your part. Now, what Lord going to do, the Holy Spirit going to continue to convict him, and Eddie going to come back to you. And every time he come back, you keep that same, you sing that same song. Let him know that he must be delivered. He must. We all must be willing to give up everything for Christ Jesus. We cannot hold anything in front or over or before God. God should not have no other God before him. And we can make our family a God.
Mm-hmm.
Because that is not the Holy Spirit through that dad. Tell your son not to get delivered. And he, and when that boy told his dad what he'd been delivered from, masturbation, pornography, he knew that he had that same problem.
Mm-hmm.
But he don't want to get rid of it. So that devil in him,
mm-hmm.
that devil in him is the one who convinced him not to continue to seek God and get delivered.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, all right. Well, let him know when he get ready to let you know and you can connect with him and bring him on, because Seven just don't use his daddy's phone. Now, that's the only thing the Lord told him not to do. Don't use his daddy's phone, because daddy said, get off the phone, because if his daddy pays the bill and the phone belongs to him, so the Lord said, get off the phone. But he can call somewhere else. You know, right now, if someone would have told Eddie, I got $100 for you, and he needed that $100, and his daddy said, don't go get the $100, and he would make arrangement to go get that $100. And the devil will open up doors for him to go get that $100. But when mm-hmm. it comes down to the things of God, the devil will hinder a person from receiving the things from God.
Mm-hmm.
So again, you just let him know, Ben King said that, you know, he's always welcome, but don't take too long, because if you take too long, the devil will harden his heart, and he won't desire to be set free. And he'll start doing really bad things. Huh? Mm-hmm.
He also asked me, he said, is there any way that he himself can get rid of him?
No.
Yeah,
who are you talking to? So now he's talking to somebody. That young boy talking to somebody. Father's what his daddy thinks that he got rid of demon. No, you can't get rid of the strong man. You tell him, that time you see him, better than he said, it's like a person who house got robbed with thieves. The house got robbed with, and they had buried the occupants in that house. The occupants in the house can't unbury themselves. They need somebody to help them. They need some help. You see, so when it comes down to the strong man, you cannot cast that strong man out yourself because he got you bound. So you need God through a human helper to help you, just like the occupants in the house need a human being to help to unbind them, you see. So, but he got that from somebody. That young boy got that idea from somebody. And he got a lot of God's children who are still in bondage to the devil, because the devil got them thinking, oh, you can pray deliverance prayers over yourself and it'll work. No, deliverance prayers over yourself, deliverance prayers, self-deliverance. They call it self-deliverance. And they don't understand that self-deliverance is not pre-deliverance. It's post-deliverance. Self-deliverance is things that you need to do to maintain and keep your deliverance, because you already is delivered. But if you've never been told free to deliver, truly deliver, then if you call yourself doing self-deliverance, Lord said all you're doing is maintaining the devils that are in you, because you're not totally delivered. So self-deliverance is what we do after we truly get delivered. These things what we do to maintain our deliverance. Because you cannot cast devils out of yourself. You can't cast a strong man out of yourself. So that's why I said that young boy got that from somebody.
And I was like, wow, we were talking about it in class in this period.
It's that demon, that spirit wife in him. It's a spirit love, a spirit wife in that young boy. Yeah. So again, you let my brother Eddie know that whenever he's ready, the conference line is there. But tell him, now make sure you tell him that I said do not take too long. Because if you take too long, the devil will harden his heart. And he would not desire to be set free. And next thing you know, he'd be having a little girlfriend and they committing fornication. And next thing you know, he'd be playing around with animals. Because those spirits are sexual demons. Bestiality is right there with those sexual demons. And he would be doing that in secret. You know, be doing things. The thing you know, his body, I'll be tattooed. Get one tattoo, end up getting another tattoo. It'll get worse and worse. And then he'll find some little boys just like him. They like minded, same goal, start hanging around, doing mischievous things. Next thing you know, his father can't do a thing with him. See, that's what the enemy wants to do in his life. See, that's what the enemy wants to do in his life. Okay? All right, Shamar. Again, you done your part, okay? So you just continue to allow the Holy Spirit to use you. Now let me unmute Sister Barbara here. I want to say something. Sister Barbara. Now, you've been listening. Now, this is how God is using this 15-year-old little boy. Shamar is 15 years old. I think it was August of last year that he called the deliverance conference line. He got delivered from spirit wife, pornography, and masturbation.
Okay.
And ever since, he fought the battle, been fighting the battle of faith, trusting the Lord. And he allowed the Lord to use him. So as the Lord sent his classmates to him, he ministers the word of God to them. He don't hold nothing back. You see how God using him? And he allowed God to use him. So now, you know, he did his part with this little boy, and now God can end up sending another little boy. See, what these little boys do, they talk to God. They're tired of their life. They know the direction they're going is wrong, and they ask the Lord what to do, and the Lord tells them. Then God connects them to Shamar. And then Shamar tells them his story. He's not ashamed to go into detail of what God delivered him from, because it has to be the same problem that they are dealing with. So he gives them hope and encouragement. And then he said, well, call the woman of God. and they call. In this case, this young boy, Eddie, called yesterday. And as we was talking and I'm about to do his session, his daddy came in the room and asked him who he talking to, what he's doing. So he told him that. He just told dad, I'm getting my deliverance from pornography and masturbation. Mm-hmm. And daddy got real low, and I knew it was the devil. The devil didn't like it in his daddy because daddy's the one who got the same problem.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Daddy got the same problem. But daddy ain't willing to be set free. So the demon and the daddy got angry. And then the little boy said, daddy said, get off the phone. And Lord said, tell him to obey him. I said, okay, obey him. Because that is his phone. He pays the utility bill, the phone bill, the light bill, and everything. So it is his phone. So get off of it. I said, but you are of age to decide which way you want to go. I said, you don't have to use his phone. You can use another phone, and you call tomorrow to get your deliverance. And that little boy was so excited. So, but I don't know what the devil through his daddy told him that said to him that night. And as you heard, little brother Shamar, the little boy was very happy.
Yeah, when you just said that, he also said that his dad said that he just doesn't want, he just don't trust everybody because something about they might try to put a spell on him or something. But I said, even if she did, which she's not, but even if she did, it wouldn't prosper because you're a child of God. It's going to ricochet back to you.
Gone. Out of mouth of babe, Sister Bob.
All right.
That was that demon spirit in him. That's that demon spirit. And plus, I told tell your father that I am a true woman of God. If he wants to listen to them sessions, give him my YouTube channel at youtube.com/MikeWorks and listen to those sessions. And I told him to do it. As a matter of fact, I was on the phone. All he had to do was talk to me. But it's that devil. Remember now, our battle is not against flesh and blood, it's against demon spirit. So it's those spirits in him. Those spirits that know who I am, they know that that young man was going to set free, and they also knew if that daddy would have talked to me, he would have been set free. But that demon kept the daddy as far away from me as possible.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then the demon finally convinced the boy, if you do this thing, you're disobeying your daddy.
Mm.
You see? And now the little boy won't call. Why? Because his love for his daddy is stronger than his love for God. But if that little boy don't get delivered, I'm telling you, his daddy one day, the Holy Spirit gonna bring that yesterday back to his remember, and he's gonna fall on his knee and repent. He's gonna try to find me and ask me to forgive him too, if he could find me. But he's gonna be so sorry in his heart that he ever done that.
Mm.
If that young boy don't get delivered, because what that man did yesterday, God is not going to let that pass by. He's going to suffer for that.
Amen.
Lord said, forbid not the children to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Touch not the least of these, my brother. He says, best that you tie a millstone around your neck and you jump in the water and you commit suicide than to bother the least of his children. He listened to the devil yesterday and did a dangerous thing. My heart aches for him because he just don't know what danger he's in now.
Right.
But Shamar, praise the Lord for raising up Shamar. God going to continue to use him mightily and helping these young boys because Eddie, just like Shamar was, a lot of young boys and girls too, infested with sexual demons. And they need to be delivered.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Shamar is an encouragement. Young, he's number 15. And he's a great encouragement to you, Sister Barbara, to allow the Lord to use you as his instrument of grace and mercy as this young man. Praise the living God. All right, everybody. I'm going to close out for today. Now, Sister Barbara, now you know I no longer hold deliverance sessions on Tuesday. It's just Wednesday and Thursday at 2. Wednesday and Thursday now at 2 p.m. Eastern, which would be 11 a.m. your time. Now you also these are the live session, but I do be posting them on my YouTube video, the archives on the YouTube video, youtube.com/MightWorks, MITEWORKS.
Wait, MITE?
WORKS.
Okay.
And also I have a second YouTube channel as well. You can go to youtube.com/C/HouseShalomORG.
Okay.
That's the second one. Okay. But you can feel free to call in and listen to the live sessions whenever you can. Because I have your caller ID as Barbara California listening. So that just let me know that you listen. Because when you ask, the Holy Spirit said, yes, allow her to do that. Because
Amen.
He's gonna teach you and show you something. Because that's how I learned. I learned a lot.
Yvonne is king.
Uh-huh.
Eddie just said his aunt just died.
Mm. Man.
Are you serious?
What, was she sick or something, or do you know?
He just texted me and said his aunt just died.
Mm.
Oh, my God.
You talk to Eddie. You see how quick death can come? So, man, you better get delivered, because you can't get in heaven with those demon spirits living in you like that. Because no darkness is going into God's kingdom. And you see how quickly your aunt died? You can drop dead just as quickly, too.
She got hit by a car.
See, that is a demon spirit. And that demon spirit is what you call an accidental demon, a demon that causes accidents. And my daughter seen those spirits on the highway. God opened up her spiritual eyes about a couple of years ago, and she seen those demon spirits on the highway. And she saw them things. They was in cages. And she saw angels holding them back. They couldn't get out of the cage. As she was traveling down the highway, she said she saw angels holding them back, but they were trying to get out the cage. And she said she knew they were trying to get out to cause her to wreck her vehicle. But she said the angels that she saw was holding them back. And she was praising and she was thanking God, because she said she had been wondering, as she was traveling to work, she had been wondering about that. And the Lord just one day just opened up her spiritual eyes and she saw it.
Wow.
So Shamar, you reply back to him and say, man, I'm sorry to hear that, but it wasn't her time to go. That was the devil, the one who took her out. So do you see what the devil would do whenever we are in his kingdom, a person's in his kingdom? So this should tell you, you need to get delivered, get those devils out of you, so that you can totally be of God. You know, you share that with him. That's terrible.
Oh, my God.
Jesus, Lord protects his children. That's why, dear heart, we have to keep our mind and affection. Just stayed on him. Just praise him. Magnify him. Thank him. Glorify him.
Yes,
because devils, they are out there. They're trying to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes, Lord.
And only God himself can protect us. He got angels protecting us.
Protect us, Lord.
Just that quick. Lord, we praise you. Thank you, Lord. Glory. All right. I'm going to go ahead and end session for today, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
Praise your Lord. Bye-bye. Okay, dear heart, I'm going to end session for today. Remember, I hold call-in delivery sessions on Wednesdays and Thursdays at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can call our deliverance conference line number 712-775-7031. Enter SS code 335950. Now, international, you too can request a session, but go to our website at housesalon.org/deliverance, and you'll read the instructions on how to install free conference call on your Android or Apple device, and that way you can use your mobile Wi-Fi to call in. You won't be using your mobile minutes. Praise the living God. So, dear heart, stay blessed. in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.